What are DDL commands in SQL? Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. In this video, we are going to see what are the different DDL commands that we have in SQL Server. What does each command describes? What is the syntax of each command? With one example for each of the DDL commands that we have in SQL Server. So as we have seen in our previous videos, that in our DDL, the full form of DDL is Data Definition Language. You are defining something about the data. You have a structure. You have a table which is in the form of a rows and column. You have to fill up some information in it, or if you do not have a table, you have to create a new table. Then you have to insert some values in it. For all these, we need some commands. Okay, so SQL is having multiple commands such as DDL, DQL, DML, DCL, TCL and so on. So in the same way, under DDL, we have create, we have alter, we have drop, we have truncate, we have rename. So let us understand about each one of those commands one by one. So what does this word create? In the name itself, we have something known as create. Create is nothing but you have to make something new. Okay, you have to create something new. Either you create a new database if you don't have it, either you create a new table, either you create a new views, either you create a new procedure, it is up to you. But if you want to create something new which is not there in your database, either your database itself is not there, we can use a create command in order to get that. So for that, what is the syntax of creating a database? The syntax of creating a database is very simple. Create database with your database name. Now, if you want to create a table, how should we create a table? The syntax for creating a table is create table, table name, you take the column name, you take the data type and you give the constraint. So if I would like to add the constraint here, and again column 2, data type, again constraint. So like this, you can add n number of columns. It is up to you. Now, let me make you understand with a very easy example. Let us consider that I don't have a database at all. So let me create a database. How should you create a database? Create. You need to create a database. Let me take a new query. In this new query, let me create a new database. Create database. What is my database name? Any name. Let me take KnowHow. I am creating what? I am creating a database. With what name? With a name KnowHow. So you can choose any name of your choice. Let me execute this one. As soon as you have executed it, we can see that the commands completed successfully. We have successfully created the database. Now, let us create a table under the database. Okay. So, what is the syntax? I am creating a table with what name? Table name. Then you have to take the column name, data type and constraint. So, if I make you understand with a very clear example, I am creating a table. What am I creating? I am creating a table with what name? Any name. Let me take training. I am opening the parenthesis. I am taking the column name. What is my column name? Such as course name. Now, you might have a question that why did I choose underscore here? The reason is that the table name and the column name, these should not have a space if you want to differentiate it. For example, I would like to go with this way. Course space name. Then SQL will think that course is a separate word, name is a separate word. So either you write underscore or you club the both. But you should not have a space between the column name and the table name. And no two table names should be the same. That is also the condition. No two column names should be the same. Alright. So now I'll take underscore course name. So that is my column name. What is the data type? So we have various data types in our SQL. So while I'm explaining you the creating a table and all, then itself I'll tell you what is the data type. Now, course name. Name is nothing but it is a character. So when I'm talking about the character, then we have to choose the character data type. For example, how will you write your name? For example, let me take my name. m.asif space H-U-S-S-A-I-N. So how will you write your name whenever you're writing somewhere on a paper or any application form and all? So we will write in this way, right? M.asif space H-U-S-S-A-I-N. So now my point is whether you will write like this or you will club the whole M-E-A-S-I-F H-U-S-S-A-I-N. You cannot club like this, right? You are using some special characters in it. You are using a dot after your surname. You are using a space for your first name and last name. So you are using some special characters in it. When you are using the special characters, the character data type will not work. You need to choose the variable character data type. That's where varchar comes into the picture. So what I'm doing, I'm choosing the data type called varchar. Now you need to tell to SQL that how much space you would like to use in order to fill up the name of the course. For example, if I am taking the student name, I am a student, ASIF. I have only 4 letters in my word Asif. So now you need to give the size as 4 here when you perfectly know what is the size of your student name. But it is very rare condition, or it is not at all possible to predict what can be the size of a student, what can be the size of a course name, right? So it is an approximate, a tentative value. So you can write a tentative value. Let me choose 200. So what is this 200 is indicating? This 200 is indicating that I can write the course names with 200 characters. So more than 200 characters, if I write some name, it will not allow. Okay. So till 200, that is the maximum that I have considered. If you want to take 1000, you can take it. That's not a problem. So whenever we are giving the character or varchar as a data type, it is a responsibility of us to even write the size of it. All right. So in the previous videos, we have also seen the constraints concept, you know, the security kind of thing that I have discussed with you so far. The point is that I have written the course name as my column name. Now I am writing the constraint not null. What is this constraint indicating? This constraint is indicating that I should not have any null values in this course name column. What should is there? I should not have any null values in this course name column. There should be some or the other value filled up in that particular course name column. If you want to create another column, comma, and you can continue like this, or you can come down in the next step and you can create it. It's up to you. Okay. So now I am writing another column name such as training ID. Now training ID, when I'm talking about ID, it is probably a number. So many such IDs will be there where you have characters also in it. For example, if you take the customer ID of your Flipkart or Amazon or Blinkit or whatever it is, okay, so your customer ID will have a character also, 1A034CS5, so something like this. So that's where you come again with the varchar. But if you have only numbers in your particular ID, then you can take integer. So that's where integer is a data type. I am taking integer. Now I will make sure that this particular ID is unique. Okay. I should not have the different IDs with the same thing. Okay. I'll take unique constraint here. That's it. Very simple. So let me come back and select that I am here in my KnowHow database. So under this KnowHow database, what I am doing, I am creating the table with the command called create. I'm creating a table with what name? With a name training called. This is my table name. So what is the first column under my training table? It is a course name. As it is a name and it is also having some special characters included in it, I'm taking varchar as my data type, which is a variable and character. And the reason for writing this 200 size is that it will make sure that it will allow the course name with 200 characters. More than 200 it will not allow. That is the maximum size I have written it here. That is a tentative. You might ask me a question. So for example, out of this 200, I have used only 10 character space. What about this 200? Remaining 190 character space. That SQL will use it for other purpose in our SQL server when we are using this varchar data type. So the constraint I am using it here is not null. Why I am using not null? I am making sure that no information or no value in this course name should have a null value. Every row should be filled up in this particular course name. So next particular column name I have considered is training ID. So ID, as I have considered, it is a number. I am choosing integer data type. I am writing the constraint unique so that I am making sure that the ID numbers that are being entered in this particular training ID column are unique. No two IDs should be same. Okay, that is the condition I have given. So if I execute it, my table is successfully created. If I want to see my table, yes, we use under DQL, we use select command. If not using an interface, how should we see these columns? That I'm going to show it to you here. Come to Object Explorer. Let me refresh my whole database. Then I'll come here. I have my KnowHow database here. Let me expand my KnowHow database. And we have tables under this KnowHow. Under these tables, we can see that we have a training table that we have created. And if I expand the columns, we have the course name column and training ID column that I have created. Okay. So this is how, using an interface, we can check the table that we have created, or we can even go through the select command also under DQL that we have seen. Now, coming to the next command that we have, it is alter. So why are we using this alter? If you want to do some modifications or if you want to add something, for example, let me consider that when I'm creating this particular table, I have created only two columns, course name and training ID. I have executed it. Then I came to know that I forgot one more column which I have to enter. So at that time, what we have to do? We have to use alter command and we have to add another column in it. Okay. So that's where alter command comes into the picture. And even if you want to modify something in a column, you can modify. So the syntax of adding a column is alter table, table name, add column name, data type. So let me walk you through here with an example. So what I'm doing, I am altering a what? I am altering a table. So what is the table name? The table name is training. Okay. I am doing the alter. I am adding something. I am doing alter. What I am altering? I am altering a table. What is the table name? Training. Now what I am doing? I want to add something. That's where I use add here. So what is the column name that I would like to add? The new column name. Let me consider the training fee. That is a column name that I would like to add. So what is the fee? Fee is nothing but money. Okay, we can use integer or money data type also. I'll go with the integer for our easy understanding. All right. So I am executing this particular alter example. We can see that the commands completed successfully. If I again walk you through this object explorer under my databases, I'll refresh it here. All right. If I open it up under my KnowHow database, under my tables, so we have the training table. Under the tables, if I expand the columns, we can see that the training fee column is there, right? So this is how you can alter and add something, add a new column in your table that you have created. In the same way, if you want to modify something, yeah, you can even modify. How to work on modify with an example, that I'm leaving it to the viewers. You can comment me with the modify example. All right. Now coming back, I'm coming with the drop. Drop is a very interesting part of our commands in SQL Server. So in this drop, if you want to remove the entire database object, so what happens in the real time is that in the real time, you might be working on some table. Okay, so unfortunately, you have to stop the work there and you have to create another new table and start deploying the data there in it, and you have to work on it. So the database or the table that you have created, that is of no use. Okay, so why to waste the space? So what you do, you have to remove it. How do you remove it? If you want to remove the entire object completely, we use drop. Okay, there is a lot of difference between drop and the delete that we have under DML, that I'm going to explain it to you when I am telling the DML commands for you in my next upcoming videos. So what will drop do? Drop will remove the entire database object. What will drop do? It will remove the, you, if you want to remove, for example, under this training, I have entered five course names. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For example, let me consider Power BI, Power Apps, SQL, then I'll go with Snowflake, then I go with Python. Okay, so I want to remove Snowflake. For example, if I want to remove the Snowflake data under my training table, I want to remove the Snowflake data. So this kind of option is not available when we use the drop command. Okay, drop will, if you want to remove the entire training table, we can remove it with the drop, but the specific rows, if you want to remove, you cannot use drop there. Okay, so that's where drop comes into the picture. So if I take the syntax of this particular drop, so drop table, what table I want to drop? I want to drop the training table. So if I execute it, you can see that the commands completed successfully. So if I go back under, and again if I refresh it, if you see here, I will refresh my database as well, KnowHow. So under this KnowHow database, you can see that no tables are there. The training table that I have created, it got dropped. I have removed the complete table from my particular database. So that's how drop works. So now coming back, truncate. It is used to delete all the data from a table. So the syntax for this is truncate table table name. So if I have entered any value under my training table, I have created a column, I have created a training name, I have a training ID, I have created a course name, that's fine. But now the point is that if I have entered the values under my training table, and if I want to remove the values of the training table, you have to use the truncate command. So the point here is that when I am removing the truncate command, your structure will not get removed. What is the structure? The structure is nothing but the column name. The column name such as my training ID. It is nothing but the course name. So this will not be removed. The column names will be there, but the data under the table, which is the under the columns, that will be removed. Alright, so the point is that the data will be removed. Okay, it will delete all the rows, but it will not remove the entire column at all. Alright, so that's where truncate comes into the picture. The next command we are going to see is rename. What exactly this rename will work and how does it work? Rename is nothing but, for example, you have created a table name already. Okay, you have created already a table. Now you want to rename it with a new name. For example, you have done a small spelling mistake in your table name that when you have previously created. Now you have to rename it with a new name, you know, by writing something correctly. So how should you rename it? So that's where I take an example. SP underscore rename. Here SP will work as a stored procedure. So what is my old table name? My old table name is training, right? Comma. I want to replace it with my new table name. New table name will be something called as TRN KnowHow. Okay, TRN KnowHow. So our old table name was training. I want to rename it with my new name TRN underscore KnowHow. So that's where I'm using the stored procedure, SP as a stored procedure underscore rename. So if I execute it, so we can see that the commands completed successfully. It is giving a small caution where it could break the scripts and stored procedures, but as we do not have any scripts and stored procedures inside it, that's not an issue. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you. So we earlier we had the name such as training. Let me refresh it. Then you can see that the table name from training, it is converted into TRN underscore KnowHow. So this is how the TRN KnowHow will also work. I mean, the rename will work. You can change your old table name into your new table name. So we have seen alter, we have seen create, we have seen drop, we have seen truncate and rename that we have under our DDL in SQL Server. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.